Did you ever have to tackle Mike Alstott, or was he always on your side?
I did. Actually, when I went to – so when Coach Dungy first came down, Mike was a rookie. I think so second year he was a rookie. And early in that training camp, I came up from free safety, and I'd heard a lot about this guy, how tough he was. And I was going to test the rookie, and he and I collided, and it was as loud as I've ever heard. And Coach Dungy grabbed me after that, and he said, "You two, you don't hit each other. You know, like that happens no more. You know, it was just a bad deal." And so I never hit Mike again until I went back as a Denver Bronco. In my first year at the Broncos, it was a big fourth and one at the end of the game.
That's A-train territory.
Yeah, we busted two and got him in the backfield. So
Really? We actually had John Lynch on, and he said that you were told that you two couldn't hit each other in practice because you hit each other harder than anyone's ever been hit.
So that was with Herm Edwards.
Okay.
When Herm Edwards was the DB coach, all right? So I guess, you know, after talking to John, that I was a clavicle breaker. So don't hit him. So
guessed you were a clavicle breaker. It seems like were you walking around being like, damn, all these guys are going on IR after they hit me.
No, but really, I mean, we were really probably, you know, less than two or three times really made contact, you know, in practice, you know. Because obviously he's going to come in the box and he wants to pop people and stuff like that. But,
and both of them are crazy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, he told you don't do that anymore? You guys don't hit each other anymore?
No, Herm told him.
Yeah.
Don't hit him.
For his protection.
Yeah.
The way he made it seem was like you guys were both not allowed to hit each other.
No, at the time he would come up to me and says, you know what, you can't come down in the box, blah, 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 and do that. But, after a while, you know, after my rookie year, you know, I had something to prove. You know, my rookie year, just like every other rookie when we're, you know,
right,
10, 12 years in the league, we're like, hey, that dude's trying, you know what I mean?
Gotta make a team.
Settle down, young boy, right?
Right.
But anyway, it was just something that just came about, and I guess those conversations between Herm Edwards and John.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Going to put you guys both on the spot here. Tough decision for fullbacks. Cowboy collar or neck roll?
Cowboy.
Neck roll.
So, speaking of that, your time in Tampa, your time in the NFL, who is the most talented player you've coached? And then maybe on top of that, who is the guy who you feel like you got the most out of? Or maybe not the most talent, but played above his talent?
Okay, probably the most talented player. It was my days actually in Kansas City. They had a guy by the name of Dale Carter.
Mm-hmm.
Defensive back, first round pick out of Tennessee. He's the most talented player I've ever coached. I mean, he was unbelievable. Probably the guy that got the most out of his ability. He's a real good friend. Actually, we're the godparents of his daughter. He's the godparents of our son, Marcus. It's John Lynch.
Ooh, okay. Yeah.
Great player. He's GM now in San Francisco. He's doing a fabulous job with San Francisco 49ers. But he is a guy that had talent but played above his talent. All here, guys. Smart guy, tough guy. Smart guys, tough guys generally can play football for a long time.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Were you on that coaching staff when it was John Lynch and Mike Alstott was on there as well?
Yep. Alstott, Lynch. Tony was the head coach. Lovie Smith was the linebacker coach. Rod Marinelli was the defensive line coach. So we had quite a crew.
Lorenzo Neal has another fullback on there. Now, we're trying to sort something out because we've talked to John Lynch and we've also talked to Mike Alstott. We're trying to figure this out. We heard that there was a rule that was put in place in practice that those two guys weren't allowed to hit each other anymore because the collisions were too violent. Is that true?
Oh, Lynch and Alstott?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, you didn't want that to happen. No, that was not happening in our practices. No, those are two powerful men. And you know, that was the old, when we used to get in the red zone, they used to have the that music about the train, you know, get on the train. When every time we got in the red zone, Alstott, you know, got in the red zone, everybody wanted us to run the football with Alstott.
Uh-huh.